Mount Everest. Forbidding, aloof, terrifying. The highest place on earth.
No, I'm sorry, we don't go there. No.
Good morning.
Oh, good morning. Do you want to go upstairs?
What?
Do you want to go upstairs? Or have you come to arrange a holiday?
To arrange a holiday.
Oh, sorry.
What's all this about going upstairs?
Oh, nothing, nothing. Now, where were you thinking of going?
India.
Ah, one of our adventure holidays.
Yes.
Well, you'd better speak to Mr. Bounder about that. Mr. Bounder, this gentleman is interested in the India Overland.
Ah, good morning. I'm Bounder of Adventure.
Morning. My name is Smoke Too Much.
What?
My name is Smoke Too Much. Mr. Smoke Too Much.
Well, you'd better cut down a bit then.
What?
You'd better cut down a bit then.
Oh, I see. I cut down a bit for Smoke Too Much.
Yes. I suppose you get people making jokes about your name all the time, eh?
No, no. Actually, it never struck me before. Smoke Too Much.
Anyway, you're interested in one of our adventure holidays, eh?
Yes, yes. I saw your advert in the Buller supplement.
What?
The Buller supplement.
The colour supplement.
Ah, yes, I'm sorry, I can't say the letter B.
C.
Yes, that's right. It's all due to a trauma I suffered when I was a schoolboy. I was attacked by a bat.
A cat?
No, a bat.
Can you say the letter K?
Oh, yes. Khaki, King, Kettle, Q8, Keeble, Bollage, Oxford.
Why don't you say the letter K instead of the letter C?
What do you mean, spell bollo with a K?
Yes.
Colour?
Yes.
Oh. That's very good. I never thought of that. Well, I saw your advert in the paper, and I've been on package tour several times, you see, and I decided that this was for me.
Oh, good.
Yes, I quite agree with you. I mean, what's the point of being treated like a sheep? I mean, I'm fed up of going abroad being treated like a sheep. What's the point of being carted around in buses surrounded by sweaty mindless oafs from Kettering and Boventry? Their cloth caps and their cardigans and their transistor radios and their Sunday mirrors complaining about the tea, or they don't make it properly here, do they not like it home? Stopping at Majorcan Bodegas, selling fish and chips and Watney's Red Barrel and Calamaris and Two Veg. Sitting in cotton sunfrocks, squirting Timothy White sun cream all over their puffy, raw, swollen, purulent flesh because they overdid it on the first day.
Absolutely, yes, I got it.
Being herded into endless hotel Miramars and Bellevues and Bontinentals with their international luxury modern roomettes and their Watney's Red Barrel and their swimming pools full of fat German businessmen pretending to be acrobats and forming pyramids and priming the children and barging into the queues. And if you're not at your table spot on seven, you miss your bowl of Campbell's cream and mushroom soup, the first item on the menu of international cuisine. And every Thursday night there's bloody cabaret in the bar featuring some tiny emaciated dago with 9-inch hips and some big fat bloated tart with her hair bilking down and a big ass presented to
Mentor.
Yes,
that's quite.
And then surrounded by adenoidal typists from Birmingham with diarrhea and flabby white legs, hairy bandy leg, what waiters call Manuel. And then once a week there's an excursion to the local Roman ruins where you can buy cherryade and melted ice cream and bleeding Watney's Red Barrel. Then one night they take you to a local restaurant with local colour and racolouring, and they show you then you sit next to a party of people from Rill who keep singing Torre Molinos, Torre Molinos, and complaining about the food. Oh, it's so greasy, isn't it? And then you get cornered by some drunken greengrocer from Luton with an Instamatic and Dr. Skull sandals and and he drones on and on and on about how Mr. Smith should be running this country and
quiet,
how
please.
Many languages Enoch Powell can speak, and he throws up all over the Cuba leaders. Sending tinted postcards of places they don't know they haven't even visited to all at number 22, weather wonderful, our room marked with an X.
Wish
you were here. Food very greasy, but we have managed to find this marvellous little place hidden away in the back
seat. Shut
up! Where you can get Watley's Red Barrel and cheese.
Shut up!
And they call it his place, mate.
Shut your bloody gob!
Oh, take it off the hook.
And there's nowhere to sleep, and the kids are vomiting and throwing up all the plastic flowers.
Operator,
and they keep telling
you
it'll only be
police.
Another hour, though you know your plane is still in Iceland waiting.
The police! Yes.
Boy, it comes to pick you up all the time.
Nine and a half.
You get to Malaga Airport.
Everybody.
body swallowing into viaform tap.
I've got a heel bar at the Mitchum Branch.
There's no water in the tap. There's no water in the pool. There's no water in the bottle.
At the Mitchum Branch.
There's a lizard in the bee there.
Yes, yes.
And he can't sleep anyway.
Here they are. Right. Just here will do fine. Bye-bye.
Good evening.
I have with me tonight an elk, Mrs. An Elk.
Miss.
You have a new theory about the Brontosaurus.
Well, can I just say here, Chris, for one moment, that I have a new theory about the Brontosaurus?
Exactly. What is it? I mean, your new theory.
Oh, what is my theory?
Yes.
Oh, what is my theory that it is? Well, Chris, you may well ask me, what is my theory?
I am asking.
Good for you. My word, yes. Well, Chris, what is it that it is, this theory of mine? Well, this is what it is. My theory that I have, that is to say, which is mine, is mine.
Yes, now, I know it's yours. What is it?
Where? What is my... This is it. My theory that belongs to me is as follows. This is how it goes. The next thing I'm going to say is my theory. Ready? My theory by A.L. brackets, Miss brackets. This theory goes as follows and begins now. All brontosauruses are thin at one end, much, much thicker in the middle, and then thin again at the far end. That is my theory. It is mine and belongs to me, and I own it and what it is too.
That's it, is it?
Spot on, Chris.
Well, Anne, this theory of yours appears to have hit the nail on the head.
And it's mine.
Yes. Thank you very much for coming along to the studio.
Thank you. My pleasure, Chris.
Next week, Britain's newest...
It's been a lot of fun.
Yes, thank you very much.
Saying newest what my theory is.
Yes, thank you. Thank you.
And whose it is.
Yes, thank you. That's all. Thank you.
Opens I have another theory. Yes. Called my second theory.
Thank you.
Or my theory number two.
Britain's newest
which I could expand if I was asked. This second theory,
yes.
Which, with the one that yes. I have said, forms
no,
the
look,
brace
I'm
of theories that I own and which are mine and which belong to me, the
ownership of the half
every time goes like this.
Ballets of Bond Street. What? No, sort of prose.
This is what it is. Yes. This is no. What it is.
Yeah. This is... Eight and a half. Hello? Yes.
Yes. Promises you that the raging cholera epidemic is nearly.
The fire brigade are here! Oh, they're coming!
Yes. Rather yes. Like the last outrageous Spanish tummy in 1660,
no,
which killed
no,
half
think,
of London.
I think they're all part of the British shoe corporation.
Chris, this side of the
crowd is a man like the other one. I'm like that now. The second theory. Seldom sing songs about Marcel Proust. Proust in his heart, but proud of
Proust in his heart. Start again.